You know, one of the probably most frequent question I've been ever asked, and we as a team at Google have ever been asked, is what is content? Well, the good people from Google, what they've done, being Google, they looked at the data. They looked at actually what people are looking and watching on YouTube. And what we've realized, what they've realized, they're happening before I joined, that there are three distinct behaviors, three buckets of behaviors that actually define what content is and could be. The first bucket is the so-called hero content. Hero is all the things that we talk about at water coolers, all those great moments, great ads, great films, great stories that we like to share and send to our friends, and basically that get our attention and gets talked about. And that's an opportunity for a brand and an agency to behave like a Hollywood blockbuster kind of film company. Then there's the other bit, the other big bucket, much bigger than the hero. If you kind of compare the branded content with the non-branded content on YouTube, that would be like the Earth compared to the Sun. So there's much, much, vastly much more non-branded content on YouTube. And you know what are the most popular categories on YouTube? It's how-tos, it's tutorials, how to braid that particular type of plait, how to repair this particular thing, how to do something. So all the things that people are searching for, that they need an answer to a problem or an answer to some particular need that they've got. And we called that bucket the help content, so another H in the framework. And the help content basically is the permission for brands and for agencies as well to behave like human beings, to listen to the needs of the people and to say, hang on, these guys are searching for these things, let's be there because we do things in that category, we can answer some of those questions. And then if it happens, then the consumer gets in touch with both a hero or a help piece of content and say, I really like that, I would like to receive a little bit more. They can click on the subscribe button on YouTube and they would expect to get episodic ongoing content along similar lines. And that is an opportunity for a brand to literally behave like HBO, for example. Start creating episodic content that is going to thrill consumers on an ongoing basis every week or every month, let's say. And also a great opportunity for agencies to behave more like proper storytellers. Those three H's constitute what we internally call the Triple H or HHH content framework, which is the most useful content planning framework that I've ever seen so far, that really reflects the behavior of real consumers, real people who are using that content, but also gives a very clear platform both for agencies and for brands to start organizing their video strategies and their content strategies around that particular framework.